today's special yoga class today. So it is going to be a meditation and a completely different yoga class. Usually for our bank holiday specials, I like to do a meditation for a good half an hour and do a good 45 minute sun salutations class. I thought that we would do something different as we're all at home. We're all going to be doing different things this year, so I'm going to give you the option of uploading a fast flow class later in the week, and for the start of the week this week, to make the most of our bank holiday, I am going to do a restorative yoga class. So this is something that I have always wanted to do, but I've never got around to writing the class that works for me and hopefully for all of us. So all you need is some either a bolster, but I haven't got any sofas which come with bolster cushions. So what I've done is I've rolled up some bath towels, and I've got two exactly the same, so they can go side by side and make a bolster. I have got a yoga block, but you can use anything else. You can use two sofa cushions, scatter cushions. We need one of these anyway to use throughout the class. But we want to use that block underneath the cushion to give it some height. So you could use two of those. I just realised I've put that behind the singing bowl so you won't be able to see it. So you've got, you could use two cushions or a block and a cushion or a book and a cushion, whatever you've got. Use this class to really relax. So most or all of the class, apart from getting into the poses, you'll have your eyes closed. So if you've got your own eye pillows, have them to hand as well, because when we're laying down, you could pop them on if you like that. Just enjoy it, really. Restorative yoga isn't for everyone, but if you are feeling like maybe you could do with relaxing a bit more, if you've got stressed about anything, if you need extra time to just think and clear things through, if you really enjoy the meditation part of our yoga classes together, then you might enjoy it. I usually find that restorative yoga I always fall back to when, if I'm very tired and I need to sleep, it will help you to sleep. Or if I haven't been very well, then restorative yoga just, it does, it restores you. It brings everything back into focus. So enjoy it. I'm then going to finish up, as some of you have been requesting, with a sound bath. I'm going to put it at the end of this class, and again, something that you've been messaging me about is that you might like the meditation to come straight after the class. So what I'll do is I'll do the restorative yoga and the sound meditation together. That way you can skip forwards through the restorative yoga if it's not for you, I understand. And then we do the sound bath, and then later in the week you'll get an upload of a faster flow yoga class, which I might record now, or I might, if it's going to be nice later in the week, I might go and do it outside again, so we will see. So enjoy yourselves, get yourselves ready to stretch in ways that we haven't done together before, and see how you get on. So we're going to start out in our normal relaxation pose. So if you take your pillow or your block and pop it underneath your head, and then we're going to take our bolster or our towels or blankets, whatever you've got, and we're going to pop them underneath our knees. So my towel has just unrolled itself. So we've got one towel there underneath our knees. You want to make them nice and level, and you want to put them right underneath your knees so that the knees are supported. This will help the lower back. You also want the knees to just go slightly wider apart than you would naturally sit, because this also helps the lower back. We're then going to roll down, laying on our backs and making sure that pillow is underneath our heads. We're feeling nice and comfy. Have a fidget around. If any of you still feel that you'd like to pop something underneath the lower back, you could put a pillow under there. And then when you're ready, let your arms fall wherever they naturally fall and let your eyes close. You could put those eye pillows on now if you've got them. So we're allowing ourselves to inhale and exhale. And we're finding in our restorative practice, exactly where we need to let go. Feeling the heartbeat in the chest. And for those of you used to my normal speed of practice, this might feel quite alien. Really being aware that we're going to be in each pose for a good long time today. In this Shavasana corpse pose, we're allowing our toes to have a little wiggle, letting them soften any tightness that the toes were holding on to. Then relaxing the arches and the ankles, letting those ankles flop. Relaxing through the lower legs into those supported knees, through the thighs and into the hips. Breathe your release into the belly. Feeling that back is comfortable, the chest is open. Breathe. And let it go. Telling yourself today that this practice doesn't have space for those thoughts that keep buzzing around in your mind. Let them all out. Your thoughts are calm and clear. Your mind is unflustered. Enjoy the space this class offers us. When you're ready, let's take a stretch of those legs. Draw the knees into the chest. Let's have a little rock from side to side. We're going to come to a spinal twist next. So if you can push your towels or bolster out of the way, you're taking your feet down so that your knees point up. Now it's up to you, you can either let the knees just twist to the right, or you can take your left leg, cross it over the right, and then exhale down. Now as you do this, you can take your block and you can put that underneath the knees, twisting over to the side. So you have a little bit of support under that leg. You then let your head fall to the left. Close those eyes. If you'd rather, the head can be central with the eye pillows on. And allow this twist to happen. This hip.
body begins to change in our restorative posing. How quickly did your mind start to wander there? Expand those hip flexors. That's where we're stretching here. The back of the hamstrings, the back of the thighs. Let's uncross that leg. Let's draw knees up to the centre. We take that block. We lift it up and over to the left. We take our legs. They're either just swishing over to the left, or the right leg has crossed over the left, and we find ourselves twisting down to the left-hand side. We feel nice and supported by that block. Our arms extend to either side. We close our eyes. Breathe and hold here. Feel this squeeze internally, the twist. Feel that release. Fidget around with your props so that you are comfortable. Nobody can tell you exactly where props need to be to make it comfy for you. Breathe and let it all out. Expand into your space. Your quietness. Has the mind wandered? Are the thoughts clear? Free up that hip. Into this pose, we uncross the leg, we swish those knees up to the centre, we have a rock from side to side, we have a release in circles if you'd like, and when you're ready we're going to come up to sitting to rearrange our props. So we're going to take these towels out of the way now. We're going to take our block and we're going to sit on it. So we put it in the middle of the mat. We want it right underneath the sitting bones. We've got the knees pointing nicely up, and we're going to gently and slowly let ourselves lower down though you can take your pillow under your back if that feels good for you. What this pose is our supported bridge pose. So you want to have, so in bridge pose, we would be up in the air like that with our hips. So it is supported, so you've got that tiny little movement of the hips being lifted by the block underneath you. Now fidget around and see if that is not enough for your back. Remember, the idea of this is to be relaxed, not to be stretching like crazy people. So if that's not enough, you can stack up, like I said about the book under the pillow. This is a good pose to be doing that with. Only if your hips are happy with that. Please don't be doing this if your hips and your back are not happy with this bridge pose. So you're thinking about expanding through the heart space, through the solar plexus, through the sacral chakras. They're all opening up. And you can take your arms, you can stretch them overhead. They could be down by the side, out by the sides. Or even if your neck is happy with it, you could interlink them under the head. Do whatever feels good for you. Fidget around and breathe. Don't fall off your block pile. If those of you who have more than one block have made a pile of blocks, they can get a bit wibbly wobbly, especially when you put pillows on top. Just bear that in mind. Now close those eyes. Eye pillows can go on if you want to pop them on. And breathe. Let this pose open up those chakras. Free any stuck energy. Breathe. And stretch. You become fluid like the water that flows under a bridge. You know that you can let it go. This is your space. This is your time. You can stretch. Let yourself in these restorative poses. You really can let everything go. When you're ready, take a deep breath, take a stretch. stretch of those fingers and a stretch of those toes. Now we're going to lift ourselves back up to sitting, being careful. You might want to roll to the side to push yourself up and off your block pile. We're going to get rid of those for now. And we're going to find our supported fish pose. So our legs will be out straight, so make sure you can get them out straight in front of you. We're going to take our bolster, again, my makeshift bolster. I'm going to pop that behind me, so right up behind your sitting bones or your tailbone. You want to make this as level as you can behind you. Those of you who use blocks, you can use one block one way and one block, so one block lengthways and one block the short mat, short end of the mat way. So you get a sort of T shape, and that will do the same opening up. So we're aiming to lay back onto these. Now have your pillow and block combination available. If you need to use them, you can use them underneath this. So we're laying back, we're opening up through the heart space, and we're opening the hands out to either side. So you can take those pillows if you want under the arms, maybe that might be quite nice. You can take the block on the other side if you've only got one of each. And we're really feeling that this is opening up that central rib cage. The flying ribs, the floating ribs are where you can hold on to so much tension. So in this space here, we're opening up. Again, you can put your eye pillows on. You can really let yourself go into your body, breathe, and take some time to explore. Is there anything going on in your body at the moment? Is there anything that you want to explore? Go in there. Gently, we roll to one hip and we allow ourselves to push up to sitting. Now when you're ready, we're going to get rid of all of that off our mats. We are going to have a rock and a roll. Just allow those backs to soften down. Some of them may just be a little bit angry by that last pose. The lower back sometimes doesn't like that. So do just be aware, if you need to take extra time, that's absolutely fine. Rocking and rolling, making that spine feel nice and happy. And in your own time, take a breath and roll ourselves all the way up. We're going to come up and over to kneeling when you're ready.
We are going to take ourselves to all fours, and we're going to come into our seal pose, which is where we thread the hand underneath the other arm. So for this pose to be made even comfier, we are going to need to take, I can never quite remember how to do this, so you need to bear with me for a minute here. We're going to take the arm through, so we're going to need to be able to, I think, we take a pillow under the head. So we've got that to lay our side of our head down onto. And we need to take some support into those legs. So I think we take those, that's it, that's what we do. We take the block, we pop it between our legs. We prop our bolster or our two towels up on our block between our legs. So we've got a nice support here behind our legs. We can then draw those toes together. We're sitting down and squishing into those towels and that block. We then take the arm, we stretch it forwards. We take the forehead down to the pillow. Look underneath that underarm. And then take the left hand and exhale it out and under the right arm. Now that arm is soft. We're opening up. We're breathing. And we are comfortable. Let it all go. Breathe that seal stretch. An inhale, draw that hand back, untwist, looking over to the left, the left hand stretches up, the forehead lowers down, we shuffle around until we're comfortable, we're stretching into seal in restorative pose, to this side, let it all breathe out, let it release.
Take a breath, curl that body up, feel that stretch. Now when you're ready, take that pillow away. We're going to take our bolster. We're going to take this and put it in front of us. We're going to take one and then the other, finding it so that it's nice and round in front. And you can make it taller by putting it up on your block and your pillow. So you can put that like that. If you like, do whatever is comfy for you. We're going to take a deep breath and we're going to find ourselves with our knees either side of our bolster. We're going to let ourselves fall down and curl into our bolster. We're comfortable in our knees. Be wherever you need to be. If you need to put extra padding or a block underneath your sit bones between your legs now, that's absolutely fine. I don't mind that at all. We breathe. We let it all go. Shuffle around for this to be comfy for you. Or baby pose is the ultimate surrender. Visualize a golden blanket of protection over your whole body. Feel this softening, feel this connecting. Child's pose. Breathe your way all the way up. Now we're going to come down onto our backs, ready for our relaxation. So you're going to take your pillow or your block, you're going to pop it under your head. You're going to get your bolster, you're going to put it underneath your knees, and you can have your block as your pillow if you'd rather. You're going to be nice and comfy. Take your blanket, pop it over you, eye pillows on. Make sure that you are supported, and remember, lower back problems, the knees are further apart. If you're comfy or close together, that's absolutely fine. We're finding ourselves coming down into our relaxation, being nice and comfy. We are taking a deep breath. We are getting super warm. Breathe that space into the body. Noticing how we feel. How has our restorative class helped us today? Breathe those arms to fall out to either side or above the head. And when you are comfortable, we're going to take those
those eye pillows and put them on. Visualizing that beautiful healing energy all around you. And allow yourself to just take a moment to send your healing energy like a healing dust into the air, like fairy dust. And when it next rains, your healing energy will fall to the earth, to the world, to wherever that healing energy is needed. Allow yourself today to visualize the space between your toes, your arches, heels and ankles. Let go. Release and relax through your calves and shins, your knees, thighs and quads. Let go. Relaxing and releasing through your whole hips and pelvis. Your belly is soft. Your chest releases. Every muscle through your whole hips and pelvis. Let's go. Relax and release from the tip of your tailbone up through each and every vertebra, all the way up to the nape of your neck. Relax and let go across the shoulders, into the shoulder blades. Relax down to the elbows and down to your wrists. Your fingers gently curl into your palms, which are warm and relaxed. That beautiful healing energy is bouncing like a golden globe of light in each hand. Release and let go through your collarbone, your neck and your throat. Every hair upon your scalp releases. Your forehead, eyebrows and eyes under your eye pillows, let go. Your nose, cheeks and ears soften. Your jaw is unclenched and your tongue falls softly within. Allow yourself today to lift up and out of your body. Feel all of us together, as if we were in a sound bath together. All of us on our mats, tucked up in our blankets with our pillows under our heads. All together,
in your place of doing yoga and meditation, enjoying the healing energy that the singing bowls, the rain stick and the wind chimes have to offer today. Enjoy this journey. See where you travel. And when the time is right to journey back, I will be right here to guide you back.
whole body now, gently and slowly drawing back to sink down upon your mats, feeling enclosed in a golden healing bubble of protective energy. This is your energy in your space. Feel nourished and healed, feel calm and relaxed. Feel in a different place to where you were at the start of this practice together. Take a deep breath when you're ready. Stretch your arms and stretch your legs. Wiggle your fingers and wiggle your toes. Visualize roots growing out of the soles of your feet, anchoring you back to the earth. Take your palms, rub them together. Rub your feet together, generate some heat. When they're nice and warm, if you've got eye pillows on, you're knocking your eye pillows off to place warmed palms over your closed eyes. Feel grounded. Feel back in your bodies, back in the here and the now. Lift those palms up, gaze into them, and see happiness, radiance, and beauty reflected. Close those palms and curl yourselves up onto your right hand sides into a fetal position. Feel rested, feel nourished and restored. Thank your bodies for taking the time to practice with me today. Enjoy the feeling, the uplift that the sound bath gives us, and enjoy the grounding that the restorative yoga brought. And as you're ready, take a deep breath and push yourselves back up to sitting. Draw those palms together as you go and let's ground down through our crown, our third eye, into our throats and down to our hearts. Thank you, everybody. Namaste. Thank you all very, very much. I will see you again later on this week for another practice. In the meantime, enjoy that. Do as many parts of it as you'd like, as often as you'd like, and I will see you all again very, very soon. Thank you, and have a wonderful, wonderful bank holiday.